Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. And recently I put up a video about the Jaclyn Hill is done with Jared Cosmetics. And there were a lot of comments in that video asking me to do the makeup that I wore in that video. So this tutorial is all about that. If you want to see how this look has been created, then please keep on watching. So what I normally do is I start off with my base, my foundation, my primer, my contour, and everything like that. But because I'm going to be using a pigment that I've just pressed myself, these are pigments from TKB Trading. Let me go ahead and open that. These are pigments from TKB Trading, and I'm going to be using these. These are pigments that I pressed myself. So I figured that I'm going to start with the eyes because I'm pretty sure that there's going to be some fallout from this. Not much, but there would be. So just to make it easier to clean up afterwards. I'm also going to be using a colored liner. It's a dark blue or deep blue liner. It's also a pigment. It's called, well, Deep Blue by TKB Trading. And I'm going to wet that with Inglot's Duraline to make it into a liner. So let's go ahead and start this. Okay, so the first thing I've done is to take a little piece of scotch tape or cello tape, you can see that, and I put that at an angle here so that well, I could get the angles correct with the eyeshadow because I'm no expert, but because you guys have requested me to redo the makeup or to film the makeup that I did on that YouTube news video. So I'm doing this, but I'm gonna refine it a little bit. So anyways, I'm gonna go in. This is my Lorac Mega Pro palette. You don't have to use this if you have any kind of, well, transition color that you prefer depending on your skin tone. I prefer to take Camel right here, which is sort of a yellowish, sort of, well, camel color. I'm taking that and I'm going to use that as my crease color and my transition shade. So I'm going to put that where my crease is. Using a, what is this? This is a Coastal Scents crease brush. I'm gonna do one eye first. Then I'm gonna go in with a pressed pigment. This is Espresso, which is more of a metallic color. And it's something that I like to use, and that's gonna go at the outer half of my eye using the Real Techniques shading brush. I'm gonna wet that with water. And then just take that color there. Whatever excess you have, tap it, because that's going to prevent fallout. So I'm just going to go ahead and do that, applying it at the outer half of my lids. I'm going to take this brush. This is the Real Techniques crease brush, which is really big for a crease brush, and I don't use it for that purpose. I'm going to wet that as well. And then I'm going to take Sugar, this one right here. Okay. These are all TKB Trading pigments, and the names that I'm giving you is actually the names on their website. So if you want to go get these products, I'm going to list down below. I'm not sponsored by any means, but they are the ones that I buy my pigments from since I started in 2009. So there. Okay, I'm going to put that at the inner half of my eyelid. I like how this sort of replicates your ring finger. So, taking that in, and then blending that through the center. So So you got that beautiful transition right there. I'm then going to go back with that same crease brush that I used for my transition color. And I'm going to go ahead and clean that. So what I've done is I took a little Q-tip and put some micellar water on there and cleaned out the edges of my eyebrows. And if I wanted to put a little bit more of that espresso, I could. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Just here. There you go. I'm going to leave it at that. And then what I'm going to do, I'm going to take deep blue. Which is this pigment. I'm gonna take a little bit of that and a drop off the Duraline and mix them together to make my eyeliner. So I'm taking about this much, which isn't much, and I'm putting that on a metal plate. And then I'm gonna put 1 to 2 drops, maybe 2 drops off the Duraline to make it a little bit easier to mix and to move around. So I dropped 2 drops. Then I'm going to mix that together and I'm going to use an angled liner like this. This is actually from an art shop, and use this as my eyeliner. So once you've got that mix, that's what you get. I'm going to take now the liner. The eyeliner brush, and I'm going to start from the inside. Okay, so now that I've done it on both sides, I'm gonna go get a brow bone color. I'm just gonna use cream right here. I think this is available at the Lorac Pro, the original one as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that underneath my brows and also help diffuse anything else. Now let me do the rest of my face with the base, the contour, and also I'm going to put some false lashes and eyebrows on. Okay, so I've got my face on. To finish the eyes, I'm going to go in with my Marc Jacobs, I think this is called Midnight Blue, and that's the highlighter. I'm going to bring that at the bottom lash line. I'm going to take a smudger brush. Smudge that. By the way, guys, I'm going on holiday to the UK in September. And I wanted to ask you guys, if there are any UK subscribers there, to let me know what I should pick up from Boots and Superdrug. Because obviously, I'm going to go shopping. Okay, the next thing is to take the Rimmel Scandalize in Nude and place that in your waterline to wake your eyes up. There you go. Now it's time for some mascara and some false lashes. So I've got the eyes done, now I'm going to go for the lips, and this is NARS Velvet Matte Lip Pencil in Tundra. And that's it. That's the finished look. Well, guys, that's it. If you like this video, give me a like. If you love the video, give me a sub. And if you have any questions on the products that have been used for this tutorial, then please do comment down below, and I'll be more than happy to help you with that. Yeah, but that's pretty much it. Except that I had my my fringe down that time, but now it's not cooperating. It's like, what the heck? Yeah, I need to put some kind of hair product for it to come down, because right now it's just a mess. Yeah, but that's pretty much how that's supposed to look, with a better organization of the fringe. But yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you all again next time. Bye.